One-Way Experiment, narrated by Scott from Exuberant Knack. It is recommended that you read the story while you listen to it with headphones. Thank you and enjoy. So in recent times I have come down with serious problems with paranoia. I have troubles sleeping due to the fact that I feel like people are watching me, and I rarely get dressed in front of a mirror as I'm always afraid something is going to be watching me from the other side. I decided to try and calm my paranoia. I would visit my doctor, who just gave me some pointless sleeping pills and false reassurance that everything will be okay. I decided to try and make myself feel better by searching up similar problems online, and I came across a whole boatload of people who feel the same way. Many of them stated how they are scared to look in their mirrors in the dark in case they will see someone's reflection. I was very surprised I wasn't the only one, and decided to try and chat to someone who suffers from the same experiences as me. So I emailed a few people before I finally met one individual. I won't say their name for privacy reasons. And we decided to meet up on a chat room to talk about it. I am guest underscore one. Guest underscore one, hello, smile. Guest underscore two, I've just emailed you. Guest underscore one, oh, what did you send me? Guest underscore two, I can't to say just open it and then leave this chat. Guest underscore one, I thought you agreed that we were going to chat for about an hour. Guest underscore two, just read it and leave or I'll leave now. Guest underscore one, okay I'll read it, but stay here. You're freaking me out. Pipe guest underscore two has left the chat pipe. 8:03 a.m. March 2nd, 2012. At this point I was worried that he had sent me some sort of virus, but I decided to go ahead and read it regardless. I set my virus blocker up and opened it up. On the inside was a document labeled onway.docs. I opened it up and inside was a long line of text which ended up being one website link. Now I was becoming cautious. Was he just trying to troll me? Perhaps it led to more discussions about the paranoia. I didn't know, but I did know that my curiosity was getting the best of me, so after scanning my computer for viruses and then putting it on red alert I clicked on the link. It sent me to what looked like an outdated blog page of some kind, and the title of the blog was One-Way Experiment underscore 01. The next couple of paragraphs are going to be extracts of text from the blog itself along with the dates. One-Way Experiment underscore 01 edit January 1st 2001 pipe 12 a.m. pipe subject 17. Hello, this is subject 17 reporting for the first test on the one-way mirror experiment. The individual's information is placed below, and we are going to be studying this individual until February 2nd 2001. Name, Ryan Lee Maxwell underscore 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 age. 23 underscore 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 house occupants, 01. The individual will be studied for both emotional and physical studies on the human interaction with one's personal reflection and how the individual reacts to certain tests that will be inflicted at a random pattern throughout the next month. We will be studying the individual through the 5 mirrors he has set up in his apartment, and we will have a series of team members taking notes from the mirror as they will watch through the one-way glass. The individual will have no idea of the team behind the mirrors watching due to the one-way glass has been reassured to be completely one-way, and it will stay that way until the end of the test. If the individual is able to see or figures out that the glass is one-way, we will take precautions to remove the subject from his home and from the tests. I look forward to this test, and I'm assured the rest of you are too. I wish good luck to the one-way team, and the first test will begin first thing tomorrow morning at 6 a.m. So be there sharp. Extract finish, subject 17. You can imagine at this point that I was completely terrified. I didn't know what to say or what to do, but I could only read on. These next extractions are going to be the test results and progress that this so-called Ryan had throughout the moderation of the test. Ryan _ Maxwell, February 1, 2001, pipe 7:54 a.m. Current moods, tired _ hungry _ thoughtful _ stressed _ anxious. Current body state, nourished _ parched. Current outspoken thoughts, exams _ tests _ university _ jobs. February 1, 2001, pipe 4:30 p.m. Current moods, worried _ fear _ relief _ tired. Current body state, fatigued _ hungry _ thirsty. Current outspoken thoughts, exam results _ romance / relationships _ sex. February 1, 2001, pipe 11:09 p.m. Test aborted _ test aborted _ subject suspicious of mirrors _ abort Ryan _ Maxwell. Now I'm no expert, but at this point I was beginning to become extremely skeptical of the validation of this blog and document. Why would the individual email me this? Perhaps for some sick joke to increase my paranoia. Or perhaps he wanted to reveal something to me that would make me see the truth behind the paranoia. I wasn't sure. The only thing that crossed my mind now were my mirrors. I have three separate mirrors in my small flat, and I began to grow increasingly scared at this point. Stupidly enough, I got out of my chair and walked over to the full-length mirror I had in my bedroom. And after a long time of breathing to calm myself down, I pressed my head to the mirror and concentrated as hard as I could, but to both my relief and my avail I saw no little men studying and taking notes of me. I just saw my silly squashed up face against the mirror. I backed away and let out a deep sigh of relief as I began to walk away, but just as was going to leave my room I heard a strange distant sound. It sounded like a car alarm going off outside my house, so I walked over to the window and peeked outside, only to see there were no parked cars. As I continued to listen to the sound, I began to make out faint words. A boat. A boat. Individual. A boat. I continued to follow the sound, and where it led to almost made me collapse. It led straight to my mirror. I stared at the mirror for a good 5 minutes, listening to this faint alarm as I felt my body shake and my eyes tear up from fear. I felt paralyzed. I tried my best to look away from the mirror, but I felt like I was forced to keep staring at it, as if I was forced to keep still. In my moments of stillness, I remembered how many days I'd walk past my mirror and stop to give myself a quick once over. But I wasn't looking for me. I remembered how at night I'd turn the mirrors away from me so I wouldn't be able to see the reflection when I sat up in my bed. I remembered how I'd have all these awful nightmares of seeing a figure climbing out of the window, coming towards my bed with a cloth in its hand as I would fade out only to wake up. It was only then did the whole thing end, did my whole ordeal come to an end. The mirror broke from the inside,